Hello, welcome to the Curiosity Show. How do you make a cloud? Well, I'm glad you asked. You can do it quite easily at the kitchen sink with a few odds and ends around the home. You'll need a glass jar and some water, about a centimetre or so in the glass jar, and a balloon. Now, you think I'm kidding, don't you? Would we kid on the Curiosity Show? Maybe sometimes, but not this time. What you do with that balloon is to tie a knot in the end before blowing it up. Just tie a nice secure knot in it there, and then turn it up the other way and slice off the other end of the balloon, about the bottom centimetre of that balloon. Just cut it away with a nice sharp pair of scissors. Now, the next thing you do is most important. You have to stretch that cut balloon across the mouth of the glass jar, stretching it over so that it stays in position. And believe it or not, you now have a cloud factory ready to go. All I need to do is to pull up on the balloon and magically a cloud will appear in there. Don't believe me? Watch carefully. Look just above the water in the jar. We need the lights in the studio down a little bit. Let's take them down so that you can see. Here we go. Watch carefully and I'll pull up and there's a cloud and another one. And each time I pull the balloon, there's another and another and another. You see, I'm producing clouds right there in the jar. It's a cloud jar, a cloud in a jar. And of course, there are real clouds in the sky almost every day. How do they form? Well, wherever you have water, whether it be in the sea or in rivers and lakes or damp earth, and where heat from the sun hits that water, you get evaporation. Warm, moist air rises and under certain conditions forms clouds. What are those conditions? Well, you're getting an illustration of it right here with the kettle. A kettle is boiling away, and above the spout, there's an invisible region there that contains water vapor. You can't see water vapor. It's absolutely invisible. But as you look higher, you do see something. You see a cloud forming above the kettle, because some of that invisible water vapor has turned back into thousands, millions of tiny little droplets of water. Now, what causes the water vapor to change back into droplets of water? Several things. One of them is a low temperature, and the studio air is much lower temperature than down around the kettle. And if I take this mirror, you'll see the effect even more dramatically. I'll hold it up here above the kettle, and if you look into the mirror, you may be able to see the kettle. There it is. It's fairly clear, but before long, it starts to fog up, because, of course, what's happening is the same as happens in the bathroom in the morning. You're getting a fog, a mist, or a cloud forming on the mirror. When that happens, you can't see yourself in the mirror. And that's happening because the mirror is cold. You've got a cold surface there, and so water droplets are forming on it. Something else can cause those water droplets to form, and that is a low pressure. And in our little cloud jar, that's what we were doing every time we pulled up the balloon. We were creating a low pressure. And of course, when water vapor from the surface of the earth rises, it gets colder, and also there's a lower pressure as well. That's why we get clouds forming up in the sky. Something else helps them as well. You know, the air is not pure. It has little particles of dust and salt and all sorts of other things in it. Those little particles actually help the droplets to form. Let me see if I can illustrate that. I'll take some paper toweling and a match, and I'll light that paper toweling. You can see that I've screwed it up so that it burns quite slowly. Then I'll blow the flame out, and I now have a smoking piece of paper. I'll take the top off our cloud jar and put that burning paper down inside there for a few seconds so that we put some smoke in there. Now, smoke, of course, is thousands of little particles. So that represents the dust and dirt and salt particles in the air. I'll put the balloon back on top, and we should find that a cloud forms in our jar even more readily when I pull the top of the balloon. Watch carefully. Every time I pull the balloon, thousands of water droplets form around thousands of smoke particles, and we get a cloud that fills the whole jar. How many different types of cloud do you know about? You might say, I don't know. There are dozens of different kinds. When you draw a picture of a cloud, you probably draw little puffy ones that look like cotton wool. Those are cumulus clouds, but there are others as well. Here's another one that I'm sure you've seen. On an overcast day, grey sky, probably stratus clouds, which are much lower down. They may even hit the tops of the nearby hills. And then way up high, perhaps 15,000 metres or more, higher than the jet planes, are the cirrus clouds that look like strands of hair or horses' tails. That's just three of the many kinds of clouds that occur in our skies. This week, see if you can find some of them.
know. Curiosity.